He defeated the Empire as Wicket the Ewok. He destroyed the evil Queen Balfmorda as Willow. He danced with David Bowie as a goblin. He defeated the Empire as Wicket. He taught Harry Potter to be a wizard as Flitwick. The evil Queen Balfmorda. And then he shut him in a vault as Grimhook. Depressed a galaxy as Marvin. He did some Elvis as the Leprechaun.
Thank you very much.
He wore a big beard as Nickelbrick. He danced a jig for Johnny Depp. He traveled abroad with an idiot.
Ah, no.
Yeah.
I sense a great disturbance in the force. This is very peculiar. I almost don't want to shake your hand, but I will. I will. Stand this way and face your crowd out there. Now, your name's John.
It is.
Whatever possessed you to come dressed like this?
Bad judgment, I think.
Bad judgment. You're in the Carrie Fisher show. You're a fan, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
For how long?
1977.
And what attracted you to her initially?
The white dress and the hair.
The white dress and the hair. So where did you buy this from? It's very authentic.
This was eBay.
eBay?
Yeah, I stitched this.
And are you married?
Girlfriend.
Girlfriend, what does she think about all this?
Not a lot.
You know, right now you're being streamed to the world.
Right.
Where do you work?
I work for HMS in Liverpool.
Do you? They're going to be watching, your work colleagues.
Probably. They will now.
Excellent. Well, I'd like to play a little game at this point. Are you up for a game? Do you know Star Wars?
A little bit.
A little bit? Okay, come and stand this way. You're going to have to look at that screen right now. As we play a game I like to call R2D Who.
R2D Who.
Right, so I'm going to show you some images from the movies, okay, of characters. And there's the first one, okay? Now they've been covered by the R2D2 dome. Do you know who this is?
Admiral Akbar.
Admiral Akbar. Let's see if you're right. Yes, that was an easy one. Well done. Okay. Let's see if you get the next one right. Okay, who's that?
Qui-Gon Jinn.
Qui-Gon Jinn, let's see if you're right. He knows his Star Wars. He's not just an ugly face. Okay, let's see the last one. Okay, that's it. You've got 2 out of 2. You, sir, win a prize. Mr. Mark Daniel has your prize. We're very generous here. What have we got, Mark, for this gentleman? Look at that, it's a Star Wars crochet playset. Crochet playset. Good to meet you. Thanks for being here. There he goes. Very strange, that is. Very strange indeed. Right. Okay, so it's on with the show, the moment you've been waiting for. Not only has my guest played the most famous princess in the galaxy, she's also an author, a script writer, and a doctor. No, not an actual medical doctor, a script doctor. Princess Leia once referred to Chewbacca as a walking carpet. She referred to Wicket as a rug. But before I bring her out here to walk all over me, let's see her in action.
Aren't you a little short for a stormtrooper?
I'm a member of the Imperial Senate on a diplomatic mission to Alderaan.
You are part of the Rebel Alliance and a traitor.
This is some rescue.
I just assumed he's a Wookiee.
I can arrange that.
Why, you half-witted, scruffy-looking nerf herder.
May the Force be with you.
Please give a royal welcome to a new Disney princess, Princess Leia, Carrie Fisher! And Gary. Welcome. There, Gary, you're here too. And Carrie, I'm just going to get your microphone for you so we can hear you. That's it. Do you
Gary
want one as well?
Gary wants the good seat. We're not speaking. Okay.
Oh, this is going to be a good interview, isn't it?
We're licking. Okay.
I had a line of questioning for Gary, but we're going to have to leave that now, aren't we? It's great to have Gary back again, isn't it? Because last time I interviewed you was in Essen for Star Wars Celebration Europe. Last time, 2 years ago. And Gary came on stage and he mauled my Ewoks, didn't he?
He did. He doesn't like Ewoks.
No, I noticed.
They sort of maul his spotlight.
I know. Well, he's become quite a celebrity, hasn't he? I mean, you know, he's got a social media presence
he
now.
He has over 30,000 followers on Instagram. So if you want to raise that number, you know.
Yeah, get following.
See how excited he is about that.
But he accompanied you to the premiere of The Force Awakens as well.
He did, and he sort of ruined the, you know, see.
What's he up? He's on.
Yeah, there was a sort of stability about the crowd until Gary got there and chased around. Who did he chase around?
Oh, he chased BB-8 around.
BB-8, he really doesn't. No, he loves BB-8.
He wanted to play ball.
He thought BB-8 was another dog, which I can't deny.
Oh, he's
and,
crying now. Why are you crying?
Now he's weeping. Does anyone have any treats?
You can sit under my desk.
And that's not a euphemism. No? Okay.
Now, have you ever, you know, thought about Gary perhaps being in a Star Wars movie?
I would love for him to be in a Star Wars. I think there are not enough pets in Star Wars. Oh. That's the only thing really it's missing, don't you think?
Would he be Leia's pet, or do you think you see him
he
as another character?
He could be anyone's pet. He would like to be my pet, I think. But he's willing to move along and go with somebody else.
Okay. Well, I've been thinking about this, you know. I've been thinking, where could we put Gary in Star Wars? And I've come up with a few ideas for you to consider. Let's have a look at the first one. This is this is Gary Yoda, or Goda. And next up, I've come up with the Guampa.
Ah.
There he is, the Guampa. Blends perfectly into that character. And we've got a Gaga Binks. And this is Salacious Gary. There he is. Salacious Gary sounds a bit like a porn star, doesn't it?
Well, with that tongue, you know, you can't deny. Oh,
now that's putting it too far now. That's just weird. What is that? That's what is that?
Warwick
Wicket?
Gary.
A Gary Wok. Gary Wok.
Yes.
There you go.
Well, that tongue is a special effect, don't you guys think so?
Well, you know what, Gary? It's funny you should say that, but when I played Wicket, I was able to get my tongue through between the teeth of the character.
I don't remember that.
You don't remember that, no.
Thank God.
Really? Right, so actually, I've got something for Gary here.
I made him nervous on that
You do? It's got warm in here all of a sudden. Okay, so I've got this certificate that we were handed that's for Gary. Look at that. He's now an honorary member of Mission Orange. He's got his own patch and everything now. So
where am I going to put the patch, though?
I don't know. It's
anybody have any guesses?
Yes. I don't think you're allowed to affix patches to dogs, actually. So.
Well, Gary will fix that, though. Well, thank you. Gary, check it out.
He's impressed.
He's been on the set of Star Wars, and he... Thank you. Gary, look, they love you. Yes! Yes, Gary. He was a tiny bit afraid of the set because he thought that they didn't really want him there after he got on the set one day, and there was... I think the Wookiee, you know, Chewie scares him. He thinks it's a very big dog. Too big to play with.
Absolutely. Well, since we last chatted, you've been working on The Force Awakens. We can now talk about
I'm not
about
allowed
it.
To talk about that.
You are now, though.
That one.
Yes,
okay.
The one that we...
I don't know what I'm not supposed to talk about, but I know it's something.
The one where the picture there will remind you of that moment. So you
I know, that's my baboon-ass hairstyle. You don't disagree. First I have the hairy earphones, and now I have baboon asses.
You've never been a big fan of the hair, have you?
Well, come on, give me a break. You want to be a fan of that hair? Oh, you would look good in the hair.
Well, what about The Empire Strikes Back when he had the sort of loopy, twirly bits? Did you like them? Plats.
Well,
No.
I think I like them better than the baboon has, for sure.
Do they not consult you on these matters?
No, actually there are worse ones, if you can imagine. They screen a lot of other ones, but no, I don't get a lot of choice.
Okay. Well, how was it being back on The Force Awakens again? I mean, were you excited or just... Well?
Yes, you feel a little old for camp. It's sort of like a camp reunion.
But you were reunited with your co-stars originally, so you were along with them, but you had a lot of younger actors with you as well.
Reunited and it feels so good.
Did it feel good?
Yes. No, yeah, it did. We just looked a little melted, Harrison. But that happens in space after a while, you'll see.
And did you kind of find the character, Gren, straight away after all this time?
The character's more worried this time. Mm. There's more people blowing up, and you get more worried as you go along.
And as you get older, you worry about more
worry
things,
about
don't
you? Sending people off into battle, and very, very relaxed when they get back.
Yeah, and she's a general now, you see, so you have more responsibilities as a character.
Way too, that's why I say it's way too much responsibility. That's why the worrying comes.
Why did she accept it?
You know, the nerf herders didn't let me decide. I just had to do whatever they say. No, they don't ask me if I want to be worried or not.
Okay.
I would like to be worried and funny.
Oh, you want a bit of comedy?
A bit of, you know, slapstick with the worrying.
Oh, okay.
Send them off with a tap dance, something
and
like
slip
that.
Slip on a banana skin.
Come back, look what you'll be missing. You know, stuff like that.
So, what do you know of the kind of the period between the end of Return of the Jedi and the beginning of The Force Awakens? Did they tell you any of that story so you were well informed?
Han's funeral. No. Between the old one.
Okay,
no.
Let's
Han and I have a very, very volatile, you know, relationship, yeah. Obviously, which leads to space divorce, as you know. No, I don't think we are divorced. We're just estranged.
I see. Space estrangement.
Yes, which is very, very rough. And we had a child who turned out to be Hitler. Naughty Hitler. Well, you'd feel bad, too, if your son did all that, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
I've got my back to you, sorry. But I did spank Adam when I first met him, so that felt good.
So he was delighted.
Well, he's very tall, so, you know, I don't think he was scared.
Tell me about working with J.J. Abrams.
J.J. is like an actor. He's very funny. He makes a very tight ship, but a fun ship. And he knows everyone's name. I mean, every extra, every crew member, everybody. So he's great to be around. I mean, I always go up to them and ask them to give me more than they're giving. So I'm a pain in the ass. But he was a great director. As is the new guy.
Of course. And how did he pitch the idea of coming back? Did he take you to lunch and say, listen, we're going to do another Star Wars?
They don't have to ask you to do another Star Wars. I mean, what? You think they come and say, now look, here's the bad and good news. Do you want to do Princess Leia again? I've been doing Princess Leia all along. So it's not like doing her again. It's just that I haven't seen as much of Harrison as our marriage would indicate.
I see.
I'm always Princess Leia. I mean, if I ran into one of you, would you call me Carrie or would you call me Leia? Both. That's true. I am Leia and Leia is me. Let's call the whole thing off. I have been Princess Leia all along and myself. So there's not much to agree to. I agreed to it immediately. And also, women my age don't work a lot in Hollywood. You get a man who's about 65 and his girlfriend is 25.
I see.
That's how it works.
That's cool.
Sometimes in life, too.
Yes. Do you have any advice for the younger members of the cast, having experienced what you have with Star Wars fandom and the whole journey you've been through for the last 40 years?
I've told Daisy not to go through the crew like wildfire. And that goes for the boys as well. So she took that advice. And not that I went through the crew like wildfire. Tiptoed, no. I gave them advice on doing a press.
I see.
I don't know what that was, though. I can't remember.
You can't remember what the advice was?
Well, you don't have to try to be funny. You just have to tell your anecdotes and say what it's like to be merchandised, which sounds like a euphemism as well. But it is very weird to be merchandised.
What did you think the first time you saw the figure of Princess Leia?
That there wasn't... I have a beauty mark. And when I say beauty, I use the term lightly. On the back, on my back. And so they forgot to put that on. But it was in the movie. Did you guys notice it? No. You were too busy looking at the front. But I liked being a shampoo where you could twist off my head, pour liquid out of my neck. And you can wash me with soap, and you can lick me because I'm a stamp. Well, no, Gary. That's why I got the Gary with the tongue. It's Gary with the tongue, not Gary with the... Okay. I've been so many things. I've been a robe, and I'm a Halloween costume.
Are you?
Yes.
Did you see the gentleman I had out here just
before? He looked so much better than I did, but...
Gary, he had a beard.
I think I would have looked good with a slight beard. Just 5 o'clock shadow. No, I thought you looked great, wherever you are.
He's over there.
Okay, yeah. You really did.
Yeah, we surrounded him with security just so he couldn't get back over here.
Do you have to wear the, bikini for stuff with your girlfriend? I don't think that would look very good.
Now, I expect, having played one of the most iconic sci-fi women in film history, you get recognized everywhere you go. Yeah?
Well, more lately, because there's been a transition into the melting. So now they've caught up with me, and so they've caught up with me.
Oh, I see what you're saying. So people didn't recognize you so much from the end of Return of the Jedi.
Yeah, no, when I was 25, I don't really look the same as when I was 25. My beauty mark does. But I am a little more melted, but now they know that, and so they find me.
And what do people say when they come up to you? I mean, what are they asking? For autographs? What's going on?
Selfies.
Selfies?
Yes.
Selfies
work. Autographs and selfies and sexual favors. I don't know.
How are you with the selfies? I mean, I get that a lot as well. You know, it's.
I'm good with selfies, although I like to, you see yourself, which you don't see when they're taking a picture, so then I have to get my neck right and everything. That's a special effect, too, that they haven't worked out yet.
Yeah, I mean, the selfie's not the most flattering photograph, is it, in the world, really?
Well, you can't control the lighting, but no, it's not.
No, well, I've actually been doing a few selfies because I like to collect them myself, as well as people taking pictures of me. When I meet someone famous, I like to have a picture with them. And I've got a little collection of Star Wars selfies that I've been doing. This first one is me and Chewbacca. Let's have a look at that. There we go. It's me and Chewie. And you can tell it's a great
likeness. Is that a euphemism? Or are you just glad to see me?
Wait till you see the next one. This is me and Lord Vader. There we go.
It's early in the morning for those kind of things.
Most impressive is what I said to him. And this last one, me and
Harrison
Ford.
That's my father.
And there's your husband.
There's my husband.
That's a good one, huh? Carrie, I wonder whether I could add a fourth one to my what is a fairly limited collection of Star Wars selfies right now. Could we do a selfie?
Of course.
Right, I don't usually do these very often, but Gary, are you going to be sitting there in the middle? What do you fancy with this?
Here we can get
Gary in it as well. So I'm all set up, you see. People aren't usually ready. Mm-hmm. It's hard to get Gary. Look up, buddy. Look up, ready? Smile. There we go. Wonderful. That's fantastic. We'll just check it as we do. Oh, that's a bit blurred, that one. That's a bit blurred. That's good. Can we do one more? It is actually blurry. But this is what... Let me do it one more time.
Oh,
now.
Here, Gary.
I see what you mean now. You see, when you're under pressure, your phone just doesn't work, does it? Right, okay. Here we go. Oh, now I've made it. Oh dear. Then panorama now. Honestly, oh, now it's facing the wrong picture of you lot then. Okay, here we go. Gary, one more and... That's great.
Okay.
I'll put that on Twitter later on for everyone to see. You know, having done that, I expect there's not one person here who wouldn't want a selfie with you and me, is there? Who would want a selfie? Look at that. Mark, get me a few people. I've got an idea. Get me a few people with camera phones.
It's Elliot. If I tap Elliot, you on the shoulder, he'll give you a number. Come over here, man.
So what I was thinking, Carrie, I've sort of come up with an idea, whether you're up for this. We could go for the world record of the most selfies in 60 seconds. You're up for that with you and me and a fan? Let's try. Okay, so...
guys, come with me.
I need to kind of ident this with some sort of sting, something to represent the speed of this, something like quick as a flash. Can you give me a sting like that? Something quick as a flash, something? Here we go. Okay. Right, so, Carrie, what we'll do, we'll set ourselves up here. You can stay where you are. Would Gary... I don't want him to get upset with all these people coming on stage all of a sudden.
No, Gary's very blasé.
Okay, can we shove him up that way a bit then? I can get a bit closer. And we'll allow a space here for these people. Look at this, herds of people. So I don't actually know whether this is a world record, if we can do this. We've got 60 seconds to do it.
No, please go back
and
sit down, please.
Can we get Robbie up here with the camera? Robbie, can you come up here? And this is going to be a sort of point of view camera now. Can we get the camera up on stage? And we're going to have 60 seconds up on the clock, ready? And the guys are here, ready. So, have your phones open, ready. I don't want to be unlocking them, you know, all that stuff. We've got to get this quick. Mark's going to manage you guys. All we've got to do is smile, okay? So, standing by. Tell me when they're ready, Mark. We're just looking at the camera when it comes in here, Carrie. They're going to bring them in. Look, each person.
Okay.
All these guys. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1. You keep count. Go! Quickly. It's facing the wrong way. Oh. That's one. Go.
This way.
Okay, number two. Oh, yes, go. It's number three. Excellent. Go. Did he take it? He's got it on timer. Go over there. Get him. Oh, excellent. Go, man. Are we going for five? Okay, good. Sound those numbers. That's six. Seven, go!
25 seconds.
Oh no!
Eight, go away!
No.
Okay, this will be, what is this, number eight now? Go!
No.
Oh. Number nine.
14 seconds.
Princess Leia.
No.
That's nine, is it nine?
Ten.
This is 10, we got 10 seconds.
Okay.
Yes, 11.
Everyone squeeze in, go, 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 everybody.
Everybody in, yeah. Oh, Gary. Thank you, guys. Oh, Gary, I'm exhausted from that. But you see what happened in that? It was textbook mistakes, wasn't it? Timers were set. It was all wrong.
It made Gary a little nervous.
Gary, your microphone there. Let me just see if it's a record.
It's okay. They will come back.
Yes, I've just been told there's no such record, although I think we have set a record for the most selfies at Star Wars Celebration at the XL Centre on a Sunday. So, well done. We have it. Oh, it's when we're clapping, isn't it? That's what's happening. It's when we're clapping.
Doesn't like praise.
Oh dear. Where's your microphone gone, Carrie?
Oh.
There it is.
My God, sorry about that.
You're back with us again.
Oh, they're the ones that all made it.
There they go. And guys, if you've got those selfies, hashtag SWCE pics, and we'll have a look at those later on. Well, maybe in the next show, actually. But so, Carrie, last time we were together as well in Essen, I remember you indulged me a recreation of our scene. Because I like to recreate scenes from the film.
I love to recreate scenes.
It was fabulous. I wonder whether, as a treat to these good people here, these over 4,000 people here, we might do it again today.
Oh, my God, I would love to do that.
You'd love to. So, yes, he said, yes, let's play Stage Wars. Stay there. I will direct you. Right. So I need a couple of bits for this. So, Carrie, I'm just getting my props. First of all, I need this spear. I need a spear here. So just got a spear. Hang on, it's never ending. That's ridiculous. I asked for a spear. Look at the state of this. I'm gonna, I'll make sure you have something. That's my spear anyway. That is ridiculous.
Very impressive. present.
Okay, what else have we got here for this? I just need my little Ewok hood here as well. There you go. So I'm going to be... when I do these, it's unusual I get to play myself, you see. I always have to play somebody else. But there we go. He's back. Well, that's nice, isn't it? Now, we haven't got any kind of goodies for you to give me. Maybe you could feed Wicked a can of Coke, maybe, for this one. Okay, so do you want to sort of lay along this chaise lounge here? I don't want to have Carrie Fisher lay on the floor, surely not. I think just relax back there, as if this is the forest floor. There we are. And you're laying with the wildlife there of the forest. That's it, make yourself comfortable. Okay, good. Now, before we do this, Carrie... He doesn't want to be a pillow, does he? That's what the problem is. He said, I'm a star now, I'm not going to be a pillow. That's it, it's just like being at home, Gary, see?
All right.
Okay, right, now, before we do this, Carrie, just relax a minute and let's remind ourselves of our moment in the film.
Like I'm stuck here. Trouble is, I don't know where here is. Maybe you can help me. Come on, sit down. I promise I won't hurt you. Now come here.
No.
All right. You want something to eat? That's right. Come on.
Oh, my feet. Gunda. If I hold you, no.
Look, it's a hat. It's not gonna hurt you. Look. You're a jittery little thing, aren't you? What is it?
Okay. That was such fun. What do you remember of that day's filming?
Nothing.
Nothing. Your microphone's down there, by the way. Where is your microphone?
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, we need to hear you. You don't remember anything
about it? I remember taking the hat off.
Yeah.
And that you were very cute.
Oh,
I remember that.
Thank you.
Not anymore, but you were very cute. No.
I made a mistake by putting this hat on before I showed the clip, and I'm absolutely boiling now. Anyway, so let's set this up then. So I need to be coming in from this side, don't I?
Yes.
So this is actually quite a good spear for an Ewok, because when they're very nervous, they can sort of poke people from afar. See? Not to get so close.
Do not scare Gary.
Will he think I'm threatening you if I do? Yeah, I've got to be careful, haven't I? Okay, Gary, I am a friend. I am not going to...
I come in peace.
Yes, indeed. Okay, so if we could, if we could have the music for the underscore... And let's now recreate the scene from all those years ago. Don't worry, Gary. I'm always going to eat my stuff. Okay, that's it. I've done that bit. Oh! You can wake up now if you want. I don't want to have to poke you again, Gary. Hang on.
Ooh. Oh.
What? What are you doing, you nervous little thing? I need subtitles for that.
It means...
No, no, don't be scared. Don't be scared. I have a Coca-Cola for you. Isn't it? It's...
Oh.
Yeah, it's the real thing.
Nice bit of endorsement. Well done. What am I going to get out of this? A lorry full of Dowling. Okay. Right, and then, I know you haven't got a hat on, then maybe your shoe.
Oh, wait.
What are you going to do next? Okay. You got a line.
I'll take my glasses off.
Okay.
Why, Miss Smith, without your glasses? Okay. Don't.
Oh.
Good boy.
Oh dear, I've been chased off my own stage. Gary, look, watch.
There you go, Gary. He's okay.
I got my piece.
Well, he's not okay, but... he's okay.
It's... Gary, how are we going to carry on? I don't want to come anywhere near you, huh? How do I go low? What do I do? Go low?
Yeah, go as low as Gary.
Go low.
No. Look, he's as low as you are, honey. Okay.
Hang on a minute. Am I really on stage in front of 4,000 people on my hands and knees with a wicked hood on? Yes, this is actually happening.
It's
thank
Dignity
you.
Day at the Star Wars Convention Center.
Right, so, Gary, I'm okay, look.
It's okay, baby.
Look,
okay. He's okay.
I'm okay.
Now, I have to make him not nervous, so you stay unnervous.
Okay.
Here, look, it's just a hat shaped like glasses.
And then I take them.
Oh.
Oh, I've heard a noise. I won't drop them in case I break them.
Yeah, and just and break Gary. Okay. Uh-oh.
And then there's a big explosion.
Yeah, there's a big explosion.
Pew! Quick, hide behind the sofa. Oh. Gary, it's me, buddy. It's me. It's just a hat. I'm doing your lines. Oh, it's sweaty now.
Go get him.
No,
get
don't him. Say that. No, you can have that. Gary, look, this is a toy. Gary,
okay.
Gary, fetch the woman. Get him. Oh, hello. I'm just going to stay here, Gary. I don't have to get up anymore.
Okay. Come here, baby.
Boy.
No, he's not down there. He's still up here. Okay.
Right.
It is a joy.
He's taking it out on my hood now.
Come
his
on.
Anger. His pent-up anger.
That's
he's
right. Just... We have him in dog therapy.
Right,
come
you
on.
Sit up there and chew that for the rest of the show. Okay. Lovely.
Don't laugh at him. I know.
Yeah. Can we carry on with the show now? We've got a couple of more features to do. Yeah? You settle
okay.
down.
Well, just, it's okay. It's okay. Look, I'm going to take this. Yeah.
And settle down. Right, and now, so Carrie, earlier on, thank you for doing that. It was a lot of fun. Wasn't it?
Come on. You'd do that too if you were up here. I would. Okay.
So, Carrie, last time we talked as well, I mentioned something called Return of the Ewok. Now, that was a film that we made alongside Return of the Jedi. Do you remember? It was like a behind-the-scenes film.
Oh, yes,
film.
I do remember.
And I promised I would send you a copy last time we spoke. Well,
And you didn't.
No, I didn't, but I've done the next best thing today. I've prepared a clip to show you.
Oh, good.
Let's
I'm
have
so
a look
glad.
At a clip from Return of the Ewok, then we'll chat about it.
know anything about Ewoks?
No. What? Oh, no, no. Ewoks, are you sure you have the right movie?
Yes, definitely. Revenge of the Jedi.
Hmm. Well, I don't know. The script's so full of surprises. I mean, it's been top secret. Maybe Carrie knows. Yeah. Let's ask her. Carrie? Hi. Listen, do you know about anything about where the Ewoks are supposed to report?
Ewoks?
Yeah, Ewoks.
Oh, I know. You should report to Jabba the Hutt's palace. It's full of unusual and wonderful things.
Yeah, that sounds right. Jabba's palace. That's on stage 8. Go that way.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
Bye. May the force be with you.
Always. That was fantastic. Come on. That was great.
Do you remember that now?
I sort of do remember that.
Yeah, it's a lovely film. It's 23 minutes long and it was never finished. And
oh,
the beauty of it is
now?
It's not available. It just gets little bits can be shown at events like this and that sort of thing. So,
and we're finishing it over time?
It'll never be finished, I don't think, now. But it's the story of me, or fictional story of me, getting the part in Return of the Jedi and then obviously putting the costume on and trying to figure out where Ewoks are supposed to be. Then I catch a rocket ship to Endor, literally, and find you guys fighting the Battle of Endor there. And then my mum and dad come and pick me up in a spaceship and take me home again.
Literally, wow. That's exactly what was the budget on that?
The budget, it was a no budget. But all of you good people gave your time. That was probably filmed during a lunch break. But everyone's in there. It's fabulous.
It really is good, and I look good, so that's important.
You did look very good indeed. Now, earlier this weekend, Carrie, I went out amongst the fans in the convention centre, with heavy security, I might add, and I wanted to play a little game with them. I asked them to complete a line of dialogue from the film, so I said the first part of it, and I wanted to see whether they could come up with the completed sentence. So I'm going to play a clip now, and you have to decide, just by looking at the person, whether you think they will indeed finish the line of dialogue. Let's find out now as we play a game. That has a nice sting that goes along with it.
Complete the Senate. Ants. Oh, I see.
I find your lack of faith.
So, do you think that guy's going to be able to finish the sentence there? Does he look like a true fan?
He might be able to finish the sentence.
You think he might be able to do it? All right, let's find out.
I find your lack of faith
disturbing.
Yes, you were right. You did it. Okay, so you can tell by looking at somebody whether they're going to be able to...
He should marry his girlfriend. He has a child.
Yeah. Would you marry him?
Just a little bit. Just the beard. Okay.
Let's have a look at the next one. Hello.
There's always a bigger...
I'm going to say no.
You're going to say no?
I don't know the end of that sentence.
Okay.
Well, I think I know it, but I don't know it.
Okay. All right. Well, let's see. Did this person complete the sentence?
There's always a bigger...
Yes! What's the answer?
Fish.
No, she got it! She didn't, and then she did. It's fish. What? There's always a bigger fish.
That was a line in Star Wars?
Yeah, it was said in The Phantom Menace. But it is an expression, isn't it, in life as well, I think.
Oh, I use that all the time.
People say it often when they see me.
What?
People always say it when they see me.
Oh, I see. I don't understand.
Okay, let's have a look. Let's have one more.
You don't know how hard I found it signing the order too.
What do you think?
I think he's going to know that.
He's a stormtrooper in a kilt.
The kilt part makes me nervous, but the stormtrooper part makes me confident.
Okay. All right, let's see if Storm McTrooper completed the sentence.
You don't know how hard I found it signing the order too.
Uh-oh. The kilt won.
Terminate your life.
Yes. Yes! We could hear the cogs whirring and you got it in the end.
What was the answer?
It was to terminate your life. It was somebody.
Yeah, I knew this.
Moff Tarkin said it to you.
I know he did, but I can't. I was very upset at the time, so I didn't remember.
You spent a lot of time being stressed and upset, didn't you, as Princess Leia?
Lately.
Yeah.
Oh no, I was upset then. Very. Well, they were going to blow up my planet.
Yeah, of course.
Record collection.
Absolutely.
Everything.
Now, before we go to questions from the audience, got one more thing to do, right? So, Carrie, if you would just shut your eyes for a moment, when I come back on, I'll say open them, and I want you to say the first thing that comes to mind.
Oh, no.
Okay? Stand by. Keep your eyes shut from now. Okay, open your eyes.
What?
Open your eyes.
There's always a bigger fish.
Hang on. Okay. Oh no, my microphone's come off now. Hang on, my microphone's come off. That
Here,
wasn't the correct answer. I've broken this now. I borrowed it off a 501st member. Oh dear, oh dear.
Come on.
So, what else would you have said? Any other ideas? It's
no.
A line from the film. It's something you said in the movie.
You think I memorized these lines so that I can remember them down through time, don't you?
The answer was, aren't you a little short for a stormtrooper?
I didn't understand that taking off the helmet was part of the thing. I thought it was to upset Gary. Okay, aren't you?
What people usually say is, take the helmet off, you're far too good looking to keep it on. But
okay, I'm sorry that I didn't know that.
Right, Mark, have we got some questions for our audience for Carrie?
Yes, I do. I have a question right over here.
Where are you?
State your name and your question.
Hi, my name's Grace. I'd just like to know how long before filming you knew about wearing the golden bikini?
Oh, I knew about the gold. Is that for me or for Warren?
That one's definitely for you.
George had me come up to San Francisco to show me sketches, and I thought he was joking. And because then they didn't have a lot of exercising, so I had to get leg lifts and stuff like that. But I really did think he was joking. He showed me sketches. That was a couple of months before. So not enough time to really get in shape. No, but I was in shape permanently then.
Very good. Thank you for that. DJ Elliot, do you have a next question? Okay.
Hello. Here.
Where's here? Oh, well, there's here.
Have you got the question? Hello, anyone got a question? Or should we go to Twitter?
Yes, right here. Catherine, we have Catherine. Right up here at the edge of the stage to your left. She's 9 years old. She has a question.
What's your favorite Star Wars movie?
Empire Strikes Back.
Why would it be your favorite, Karen?
It's the spiritual Star Wars. It's the John Lennon Star Wars.
I see.
Yes.
Very good. Thank you for your question. Should we go to a Twitter question next? Have we got any? People have been tweeting their questions via the hashtag SWCECarrie. Who is your favorite character from the franchise, and can you sort it out that Gary gets an action figure?
Oh, man, I really think it's important that Gary gets an action figure with, you know, the tongue as a little, you know, extra little moment on the side. Who's my favorite character? Well, in the yes and no way, I like Jabba because I like to kill him. So I like to get him. Yeah, I like to kill him in all sizes.
But so, have you chosen a character, a favorite one?
Well, that was Jabba.
Oh. Okay.
Am I not allowed to choose Jabba?
You can choose Jabba. You can.
Okay,
you can.
I'll choose myself.
Okay. Didn't get the hint.
No, I couldn't get any. Do you have one?
I'm a character.
I know that you're a character, but I didn't know you were an action figure,
Hang
too.
Hang on a minute.
Is that real?
Is that real? Yes, it is real. It's a giant version of the action figure, obviously, in reality.
Well, I'm very excited for you, then.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. You know you've made it, don't you, when you're created in plastic?
Yes.
Yes.
Are you a stamp, too?
No, I've never been a stamp.
See, it's really good when you're a stamp.
Are you, All right, then. All right, Miss Fisher. Are you a Lego minifigure?
I yes. think so.
Yeah, all right. Have you got four Lego minifigures of characters you've played?
I don't know about four, but I think
well,
I have...
Well, thank you very much. I think I hold that record. I rest my case.
You have four Lego minifigures?
Yeah, different characters, yeah. There's a Wicket figure.
Yeah.
There's a Professor Flitwick from Harry Potter.
Oh, I see. We're going to other movies.
Oh,
now.
Yeah,
that's
we're allowed
cheating.
To. There's no rules. So
that's
you can't
cheating,
that.
I think. Yeah. Okay, yeah, there's no Burbs figures. And
but you'll
there
have two
might be
now, at least. I think you've got more.
Blues people. Brothers. Oh. No, I'm not an actor. The Mystery Woman with a Flamethrower.
There'd be a Lego Blues Brothers license.
That
no, would be
you win on that, and I'm enraged at you. Get him, Gary.
On that note, let's go to another question from the floor.
All right, back here in the back by the audio.
Okay.
What's your favorite scene with Harrison Ford in a Star Wars saga?
In the new Star Wars, I liked, there was a little bit where I kind of yell at him. Not really yell, but it's fun to go back to the old days when we, you know, treated each other badly. That's always my favorite part, is treating Harrison badly. I mean, Han.
Right, let's go to Twitter again. Let's see what we got from Twitter. Okay. What's being your favorite and least favorite parts of coming back to play Leia in the new trilogy? So
I do not like looking at myself in giant size. It doesn't make for, you know, older women.
I see.
When you have, what is that called when you, it makes you very, you know,
ugly.
Your wrinkles all show.
Magnification? I don't know. What do you mean?
It is. HD is not friendly.
Oh, HD, yes.
To the older, over 40s. It's not made for that.
No.
So I wept through the first, I'm not kidding. Thank you, darling. I love you, too.
They all
you
love you in HD.
You don't mind my wrinkles and my puffs and my sad, oh, and my baboon ass.
Okay, let's go to another question from the floor.
All right, over here on the left side of the stage.
Yep.
Hi, Carrie. I still think you're as beautiful as you were back in 1977.
Oh, thank you.
Really, really. It's a bit of a two-part question, so sorry. Would Gary like some peanuts? Because I noticed you asked him to order a snack earlier. And this might be a bit of a personal question, but do you still wear the bikini?
I'm wearing the bikini now.
Oh, hell yeah.
It's been modified for older usage, but I am wearing it now.
Good, I'm glad we cleared that up. And okay, DJ Elliot, what do you have for us?
Hi, I was wondering if you could tell us a particular funny story from set.
Which movie? No, let me see.
Any of them.
Oh, there's some bad ones where I don't remember my dialogue. I don't like those stories, though. Well, you know, when we were doing the scene in the trash compactor, there was a thing that was supposed to be called a Dianoga. That was the thing under the water that grabbed Mark. And so we're in the trash compactor, and Mark lifts up a piece of trash and says, "Pardon me, George, could this be Dianoga poo-poo?" So that was good.
That's fantastic. Mark, do we have another question in the room?
Yes, way in the back, stage left, up in the rafters.
Ah, yeah.
Hi, Gary. Do you take a new lover in episode 8?
God, I hope so. If I do, I don't know it, but the dress is awfully large, so you never know. It could be a new kind of special effect that they add in post. I hope.
Okay, let's go back to Twitter for the next question. Okay, this is from somebody called Can Skywalker. How often do people call you Princess Leia instead of your real name? We sort of talked about this earlier, didn't we?
Well, I have a feeling this person would. No, I often go into, my favorite thing is going into a airport and someone saying to me, Leia, and am I meant to go, yes? So I am, yes, called Leia, and it's very hard for me not to turn around, which is depressing. But I often turn around, and that's more depressing. And yet not. What do you think? Don't you want to be called Leia, sir?
Yeah. Okay, DJ Elliot.
Elliot, this will be our last question, I was told.
Hi. For those of us that were at the first panel with Mark Hamill, we're curious about why you went to the Wax Museum without him.
Mark's email, which is... Oh, Mark's email does not include his name. And I often, as I don't remember, aren't you a little short for a stormtrooper, don't remember people's non-names, email names. So when he wrote to me about it, doesn't this sound like a lie? Anytime you try to convince someone of something, it sounds like a lie. That's what an acting trip. So when he wrote to me, I never saw it. And obviously, we both were longing to go over and see ourselves in wax. So that was the interesting thing, was we had our little connection as twins. And we both wanted to go over and see the wax figure. But I didn't see his email. That's my story anyway, and I'm sticking to it. Why would I want to go without Mark? It's a much better story that I went with Mark. And now, ask him this when you see him. All of you. Why would I not? Does he want to go now? I keep asking him. Do I say to him, do you want to go back? I said yesterday, let's go tonight. And he said, and you can say this to him when you see him, all of you, I have tickets for the theater. Now, doesn't that sound like a lie? So, please go get him. If it's a problem for him, if we have not gone before, I'm willing. So I want literally every single one of you to go up to him and say, go with her now. Hashtag go with her now. Dot wax figure.
Well, Carrie, I'm so thrilled we've had the real Carrie Fisher here this afternoon.
And I'm thrilled we had the real Warwick.
The real Warwick. I've not been made in wax.
Well, never. You will be, I can tell.
It would only take one small candle. Melted into a Warwick Davis shape.
All right, well, I'll get that.
Maybe we'll suggest
it. Look, and now Gary likes you more.
I know, I think so.
It's calmed down.
He has indeed. Well, it's been such a delight to share the stage with you today.
And you, sir.
And ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the wonderful Carrie Fisher and Gary. Ladies and gentlemen, there's loads more to come on this stage later on. In an hour's time, I'll be joined by Mr. Ray Park right here on this stage. And then later on this afternoon, future filmmakers and the closing ceremony.